little brother.
We hear you've got a new job.
The kingdom needs us. If we all stick together, we can save people.
Why would we ever do that?
Every kid wants to be a hero, but do you know how many actually go pro?
I hate my family.
Welcome to Extra Butter at Home. This week, celebrating a revolutionary new show hitting all of your screens. By revolutionary, we mean it might be the most inappropriate thing ever made. What is Crossing Swords? You're about to find out on this Extra Butter.
This is Extra Butter and our All Crossing Swords edition, to which you're all replying right now. What's Crossing Swords? Well, that's what I'm going to get into in the next half hour. Thanks for hanging out with us. Look, if you're watching Extra Butter on YouTube, be sure and like and subscribe. If not, thanks so much to the men and women watching on AFN all over the world. All right, be warned. What is Crossing Swords, you might ask? Well, let me tell you, it's a Hulu original series, and you're not going to hear anybody tell you this, but I'm going to tell you right now. It's loosely based on the little people. Remember the Fisher-Price toys we grew up with when we were like, yo, so high? Be warned, this isn't for kids. This might be the most adult thing that I have ever watched. There's so much I want to tell you about this, but I pride myself on Extra Butter to be keeping it for all ages and all audiences. This is not. Hey, can we show the trailer? Okay, I got permission to show the trailer, so here's a little sample. Take a look.
Wow! I'm gonna be the best knight the kingdom has ever seen!
Oh.
10 years of training has led to this. How am I supposed to be a knight for these people?
This is a cesspool.
Nothing separates the men from the boys like combat. Oh.
Why do we have to strip for this?
Like I said, men from the boys.
Patrick, we can't put every prisoner to death.
Exactly.
An execution is a sometimes treat, like ice cream.
You're a witch?
I'm not a witch. I'm just asking for equal pay for men and women.
Witch! Witch!
What's in here?
The kingdom is super.
I'm here to save you!
Ew. Like, what are you, obsessed with me? Stalker.
It's my job to polish you wet turds into diamonds!
I know how to field dress a man and use him as a sleeping bag. Your skin looks cozy as hell.
Thank you.
All right, they couldn't even show you the best parts in that trailer. If I haven't mentioned it yet, it's brought to you by the people who brought you Robot Chicken, Adult Swim, Seth Green, and that entire tribe. We're jumping in right now via Zoom into a behind-the-scenes kind of virtual set tour somewhere in Burbank right now. Let's take a look.
I'm training to be a knight.
Every kid wants to be a knight. Sink or swim, hero. I'm putting a pool table in your bedroom and...
Sounds like both of you have dreams that won't come true.
Crossing Swords is the story of Patrick, this little peg figure here, and his journey to become a squire. The deeper he gets, the more he realizes that everything's just completely screwed up.
This is a cesspool.
A cesspool of shrimp cocktail.
I've never really seen any kind of stop animation like this. I mean, certainly not Gumby, but the Lego movie, that's for sure.
The show is meant to be really fun and colorful, but in an adult way where there's a lot of mayhem.
This show is unique because it's actually stop motion as opposed to most other animation, which is now all computer generated.
Stop motion, it's a little bit janky and a little bit stylized. And Patrick, he has a lot of imperfections, and I feel like together they go hand in hand.
Why do we have to strip for this?
Who cares?
There's something nostalgic about watching it, and they're super funny too.
Just stare at their... In this case, it's perfectly appropriate.
I found it really funny and ridiculous and dirty and surprising as well.
The comedy of Crossing Swords is, I'd say, like Mel Brooks on bath salts.
Ross, did you find Blossom?
No, but I did find a lot of drugs.
I am a big fan of filthy comedy.
He threw mud in my face!
That was not mud.
We have an incredible voice cast. We're really elevating what's on the page.
We just played around until we found something that sounded like it would come out of this little guy.
My girlfriend's evil and I'm covered in I'm working through some residual anger.
It's like these toys are coming to life.
You take your favorite fantasy stories and then just add a ridiculous twist.
You have these play school figurines saying,
holy cracker.
It's fantastic.
All right, so those are the creators, Tom Root and Harv Harvatine. Again, the guys with Seth Green who bring you Robot Chicken. So many great voices are involved in this. You got Academy Award winners. You got Tony Hale, you probably know him best as Forky in Toy Story. And this guy, Nicholas Hoult. In fact, when we come back, I'm gonna zoom into the home of Nicholas Hoult. You know him from Warm Bodies and The Favorite and a lot of other movies. And the creators, the rest of this show is gonna be all Zoom as we continue Extra Butter at Home, the all Crossing Swords edition. We'll be right back.
Password. But spelled out, capital S, and the I's are exclamation points.
I only want to be a knight to help people in need, because the king is a terrible ruler.
We need a public execution. You go down to the dungeons for me and pick out a real all-star, you know, a true bull.
Oh, my God.
Hey, welcome back to Extra Butter. As promised, it is our Zoom edition, a virtual set visit, and a cool set at that. It is Crossing Swords, a Hulu original. It is awesome. Without further ado, its creators, Tom Root, John Harvatine IV, and Nicholas Hoult. Good morning. How are you guys?
Good morning. Good
morning. Very nice good. To see you.
I'm so geeked out. I don't know if the adrenaline is carrying forward, if you're seeing the excitement on my face, but nothing has touched me so deeply. And I'm also a little disturbed that this movie, this series rather, has affected me so much. Are you getting similar reactions from like-minded people who appreciate the twistedness?
We're getting a lot of shock and horror. We're telling such twisted stories with such cute little faces, saying such terrible words, but I think that was our point all along. So mission accomplished.
Yeah, that's great. So Tom, I wanted to ask you, I'm glad he said horror, because a lot of this, it acts like pop-out scares, only it's pop-out inappropriate humor. You're not ready for it, and it's shocking off. Intentional?
Yeah, we try not to overdo it. We don't always succeed because it's really tempting when the characters look the way they do to have them do inappropriate stuff. But we definitely, it's an intentional thing that we're doing to get the nastiest possible trash coming out of these little mouths.
And believe me, it's probably nothing people haven't done at some point on their own. We all played with toys inappropriately. Let's be honest. In fact, a few minutes ago in the set visit room, you guys were talking about that innate thing that a lot of guys did when they were kids, and that is strap firecrackers, do the most inappropriate, obnoxious, horrific things to their toys. Nicholas, were you ever inappropriately angry towards your toys?
I didn't grow up with firecrackers, so I never strapped a toy to a firecracker or anything. Did I treat them badly at times? Probably. but nothing's coming to mind at the moment that's horrific. I think more as an adult now viewing this, I'm like, this is a really fun juxtaposition to see, as you said, these cute characters.
You know why you didn't grow up with firecrackers? Because of guys like us. We ruined it for you.
Yeah.
Is there something refreshing or safe about being in something that's not live action? If you were in a live action series that had this many, you know, edgy gags, you might be worried. You'd be bumping into someone and they'd come up to you on the street and say, I can't believe I watched that with my grandma. However, you can hide behind the animation. Am I right?
I don't know. I don't think I worry going into things what the reaction will be, because you can't really have control over that. But I just tried to find things that I like, and the writing in this was something that really made me chuckle. And then to see the artistry and the way that these guys shoot the stop motion and build all the sets and everything, I was like, well, that's incredible. So those things combined was something that I would personally enjoy. So hopefully other people will too.
So what's one of the first moments I want each of you to say, when I've had a good day or I've done something I'm proud of, at the end of the day, I'll say, you won't believe what I did. It worked today. So tell me about that day on the set or that day in the creation of this for each of you where you had one of those moments you couldn't wait to tell everybody about. We'll start with you, Nick.
For me, I think it was the episode where Patrick has to get circumcised. I think that's that one really, I really didn't expect it when I was reading it. And I thought it was just really funny. And I was like, okay, this is, I mean, I love the series from the beginning, but that's one that just sticks out in my memories particularly.
We had to watch it over and over. And I actually started feeling like I might either throw up or pass out. So yeah, we even grossed out ourselves at a certain point. So I was very proud of that.
Was Robot Chicken really just training ground for this? Was all roads were leading to this?
Yeah, absolutely. We learned a lot in Robot Chicken on how to do toy animation and how to, you know, animate blood and how to animate things with such limitations. So yeah, Robot Chicken definitely helped us learn the physics and the tools used to make the show.
Guys, look what Andy's aunt got him from Gwyneth Paltrow's website. Say hi to Pinko!
Hello.
What are you?
I am a Swedish creativity object designed in conjunction with free space theory, which encourages cognitive freedom. For instance, your cowboy concept restricts imaginative thinking, whereas I am conceptually neutral. Andy chooses what I am, not the manufacturer.
I already hate this.
Hey, stop that! We're all friends here, Mr. Potato Head. Pinko, let me be the first to welcome you and shake your hand.
How can I shake your hand?
With your hand, right there.
Who said that's a hand? Maybe I'm a magical train and that hand is a wheel. Maybe I'm a candy-making machine or a hotel for tiny clowns. My concept will come from Andy's brain, not yours.
Whoa, no need to get upset, man.
Man? How dare you? Maybe I'm a woman. Maybe I'm an asexual space creature. Andy should decide.
Hey, shh! Andy's coming!
I can't wait to begin growing creatively with Andy.
I am Pinko. You decide what I am, okay? You're trash.
Hey, can someone give me a hand?
Who says these are hands?
Awesome. You guys, it's nothing short of a masterpiece. I can't wait till everybody's talking about this. Thanks for hanging out with me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
When we come back on Extra Butter, the lovely and talented Tony Hale. Don't move. Thanks, guys.
I need your help.
Okay, but you think anyone can tell my armor is 90% aluminum foil?
This kingdom is corrupt as hell.
And that's why I burned down the water park for the insurance money.
Was the water park insured?
I'm gonna take you under my wing, kid. You're gonna learn from the best, the old master himself. Oh, the adventures you're gonna have.
Oh, no. What have I done?
Welcome back to Extra Butter. Like I promised, it's our all-crossing swords because I've never been more excited about an original series, and it disturbs a lot of people that I love it so much because it borderline is inappropriate. As promised, you guys, it's Tony and Adam from their homes. Good morning.
Hello.
Hello. I wouldn't even say borderline is inappropriate. I would say spot on inappropriate.
The way I love horror movies, pop-out scares, I love the pop-out obscenities in this. How about you?
Yeah, well, I think horror and comedy are very close. You know, you're surprising people, and so I think that our shocks were laughs here.
Is there a moment in the script that you couldn't wait to see how this looked, and now after painstakingly voicing it and then going away and waiting for it to be happening, to actually visually see it all come together that blew your mind?
I think all of it, you know, I that's part of the fun of doing something like this is you get to be, you record it, you spend the time doing it, and then you really do have to like imagine what it's all going to come together as. And then seeing it like this, you're like really blown away. Wow, it's amazing.
The barometer by which I judge my friends pretty much is how they're going to react to this or any comedy like this.
Yeah, a lot of people say that.
Yeah. How about you? Will this polarize your friends? Bring both of them aboard?
I judge my friends based on their merit and not their taste, but I could totally see how if someone didn't like this, I would go, well, you're not going to like the rest of my library.
Way to take the high road. It's a shame that you and the cast members weren't all together because sometimes I'd love to see a reunion of all the voices. How about you?
Yeah, it's an amazing cast. I'm lucky to be a part of it. I think that that's how you do animation. You know, rarely are you together with the person you're doing the scene with. So that's part of the fun of it too, is that you get to kind of put all your attention on yourself, and it's a different type of acting.
Is there a moment that you secretly can't wait for audiences to see, or that you you can't wait for your friends to see? Is there a moment that works best for you? It's hard to break down into one moment, but you know.
I'm excited to see how my friends react to more of the sensual moments that are with these toys. I think that will be a real moment.
Yeah, I was anxious to see where the animators went with that. I mean, knowing what it's based on, I thought, but wait a minute. Anatomically, I don't think there's anything to worry about. Oh, yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot to be seen.
Yeah, the logic of the anatomy of the characters is quite enthralling.
You were remarkable in this. You know, I think historically, there's probably a time where you were probably most proud that you were a part of the Iron Man franchise. Au contraire, my friend. Historically, you're so proud you were a part of this.
Yes, no. Iron Man franchise, Star Wars franchise, that doesn't hold a candle to Crossing Swords.
Well, you're remarkable, and I'm so glad you're a part of this. Thanks for hanging out with me.
Thank you, and again, I'm so impressed with your set. It's amazing what you are doing.
I'm so impressed with the fraction of what I believe is a four-post bed that I'm seeing in your room.
I didn't even make the bed. I look like I'm a journalist that's been taken hostage.
You know, not a bad idea these times. Try it all. Thank you, sir. Hey, welcome back to a very special edition of Extra Butter, doing it all on Zoom, but with some really cool people behind this. Hulu's original Crossing Swords. Everybody say hi.
Hi!
Yo!
Are you a dapper fellow? Look at how you're dressed at 9:30 in the morning. Well,
you guys, I never knew. Like, it's always, if I wear a t-shirt and no pants, everybody else is dressed up. So at least my mom always said, be the most dressed up, dress like you're doing something better.
I love your mom.
And that's amazing. Adam, are you advice. Right, I love your mom.
that is, yes, barely, but they're, yes. Mark, is that a statue of you in the back corner? What is that?
It's a stormtrooper with a baseball cap.
Oh my God, dude. You're my spirit animal. All right, go ahead. First question.
All right, we got a tight shot on you, so I see nothing embarrassing behind you. For all three of you, where are you and how are you?
I'm having a banana, and I'm in my bedroom, as a matter of fact. Nice lighting, etc.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Adam?
Right now I'm in my home office. My buddy painted that. Just kind of chilling, having some coffee. Got my socks here, might put them on. We'll see what the day holds. You know, I'm turning 38 tomorrow, Mark, so I'm kind of flying by the seat of my pants, trying to just live it up. Any birthday suggestions, Mark? As my character Ruben would say, any birthday suggestions, Mark?
Well, you know, because we have to do it virtual, I say get little peg characters and have them do everything you wish you could do, because nothing's illegal in the peg toy world. Am I right?
Dude, you are
just
right.
That is least.
That is a great way to describe this show, by the way.
Tara, great glimpse into your home. I love the artwork behind you.
Thank you. This is my studio. This is where all the magic happens. We call this the money chair. It's green. I have my mic. I have some fan art. I have kids' pictures and toys. I do all my cameos in here. Do you guys do cameos?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It's like the most amazing thing. Like people... I all weekend I donated my cameos to Black Girls Code, which is like this amazing organization that teaches Black girls from the ages of 7 to 17 all about STEM and code and get them jobs, which is amazing. So I just sit here like doing funny voices all day, and this is where I am all day.
This is our job, Mark. This is what we do to make money and support our families or our dogs.
I get it. Let's go down the line. Sarah, let's start with you. The moment to look for. Season 1, episode 1, which is also the pilot, what's the moment to look for, your proudest moment?
Oh, episode 1, season 1, the proudest moment. Gosh, anytime she's, like, watch for her. She's so fun. Anytime she's, that's the comedy with her. You know, she's this really pretty, cool little toy, and you think, oh, she's so sweet, and then she'll swear.
It's Adam's birthday Eve. All right, so, Alanna, I think we'll give you time to consume. Banana. So now tell us your favorite moment, the moment you can't.
Oh my God. Well, it's funny. The audition, when I first read the first line, was, have you ever an 1800 pound chandelier hastily bolted the canvas tint? And when I first, you know, I thought, okay, she's definitely gonna have to study Queen's English. Let's watch a little Helen Mirren on YouTube. And then it all finally came together. First episode is so funny because it just immediately establishes the fact that she is one hell of a horn dog, and she will do anything to spread her seed. And yeah, she has a lot of love to give, and she is obsessed with youth, and she'll go to extreme lengths to preserve her youthful glow, whether it's windsurfing or a singing career, etc. But she is so much fun, and I'm so proud to be the voice behind her.
You guys should be. This is the most awesome, mind-blowing animated experience I've ever had. Adam, I don't want to leave you out. Credits are rolling right now, so you get the last words in the show. Take it.
Well, my favorite part in the first episode was T and I, Coral and Ruben, trying to fight for who should get executed for the fame and fortune and glamour that comes with it. But this is why I love our characters. We saw how it went down, and Ruben was like, you know what? I'd rather go inspire some kids. Thanks for having us, Mark. Extra butter, baby.